Good evening, students. Let me continue the previous videos. That is, comedies could be classified as classical comedy and romantic comedy, like the tragedies. So the classical form following the Greek and Latin model, that is following three units. Okay, and Aristotle also says that it should give you a moral message, and the characters should not be noble. They should have all the foolish and follies and flaws and weakness and all the immoral behaviors. And from that, audience should learn that they should not follow such kind of immoral behaviors. Okay, so that is said to be classical comedies. And Ben Jonson and some Restoration playwrights, English playwrights, followed the classical model of comedies. And Ben Jonson's plays, he followed all the three units in his comedies. Okay, Ben Jonson. And his comedies are called as comedy of humors. Okay, why it is called as comedy of humors? Because all persons have certain number of fluids. There are some kind of fluids in the sense, some temperament, some character. Okay. If it is exaggerated, then say for example, the fluid of laziness. If I have more number of that lazy fluid, then I will be a lazy man. Okay, since I am the lazy man, and let's say Ben Jonson is making on the character called a lazy man, and because of his laziness he suffers, and comedy is provoked. Okay, so then one particular temperament, one personal character or personality, laziness is exaggerated, and from that the audience is audience laughter is provoked. Okay, so another one is let's say anger. Okay, one particular character's anger, he has lots of anger, and because of that he suffers a lot, and audience laughter is provoked. Okay, so one particular character temperament is exaggerated, and from that audiences get full of laughter. Okay, so such kind of comedies are called a comedy of humor, and Ben Jonson alone wrote such kind of comedy of humors. Okay, and then comedy of manners. Okay, another kind of comedy called as comedy of manners. Comedy of manners was written by Restoration playwright. Okay, that is a neoclassical PH playwright. Okay, what do you mean by comedy of manners? Comedy of manners, the story should is based on rich or upper class people. Okay. And all the behaviors of upper middle class people or rich people, they unnecessarily spend lots of money on makeup just to show off the richness. They do many foolish things, and because of that audience laughter is provoked, audience get a complete laughter. Okay, so the upper class people and rich people are satirized in comedy of manners. Such kind of plays are called as comedy of manners. So comedy of manners are the plays which satirizes rich people and upper middle class people. Okay, and their way of life or immoral way of life, and common people should not lead such kind of immoral way of life. That is the message of those plays. So that is, they are all called as comedy of manners. And then came the gentle comedy of Colley Kibler, and sentimental comedy in which there are excess of melodrama, moralizing, and less wit and laughter. And then sentimental comedy is also comes under the banner of comedy. Sentimental comedy is, let's say, in detail explanation of tragic comedy. Tragic comedy is different from sentimental comedy. Let me talk about tragic comedy in the separate topic, in a separate video. But sentimental comedy, it will have lots of sentiment scenes, okay, very emotional scenes, okay, and at the same time, that there would be lots of comedy scenes. At the same time, there are many serious sins as well as comedy serious sins and sentimental sins, but in the end it has a happy ending. Okay, that is called as the sentimental comedy. So sentimental comedy, it should have happy ending, but there should be lots of sentimental sins, lots of emotional sins, and also serious sins, and also typical comedy sins. Okay, so that is called as sentimental comedies. And anti-sentimental comedy. Anti-sentimental comedies, from the beginning till the end, it is but there is no serious sins, full of comedy sins. Okay, that is called as anti-sentimental sins. Anti-sentimental comedy. Okay, they don't focus on moral message. Anti-sentimental scenes, comedies, anti-sentimental comedies do not focus on moral message or satirizing upper middle class or rich people. They don't even focus on moral messages also. Typical comedies, from the beginning till the end, you will completely laugh. Okay, that is called as anti-sentimental comedies. Okay, and then we shall move to next paragraph. The language and atmosphere of the English comedy remained fairly remote and those of ordinary life until the 1860s, when T.A.W. Robertson's play Castle appeared. Okay, so most of the English comedies are completely away from life. They cannot happen in real life. Maybe use of fantasy elements, magic elements. So there is a witch, and the witch is enchanting a character. Okay, so such things cannot happen in real life, and this character become invisible, this character became a donkey, this character became a monkey. So okay, such thing cannot happen in real life. In Shakespeare's Midsummer's Night Dream, a character became donkey, and another character became monkey. This happens in Dr. Faustus also. Dr. Faustus is also a mixing of magical thing and fantasy element. Such thing cannot happen in real life. Okay, in most of the English comedies, they don't happen, scenes and characters, we don't see such kind of incidents or characters in real life. Okay, only in from 1860s, especially with Robertson's play, cast, real life comedies began flourishing in English literature, only in 1860s. Then onwards, English comedy began to employ everyday language and familiar subjects, culminating in the plays of Bernard Shaw and Galsworthy in modern times. So that happened with real life characters and real life incidents. Comedy is based on real life characters and real life incidents, and continued with Bernard Shaw and Galsworthy. The comedy of dialogue, in which incidents and action are subordinated to witty dialogue and narration, flourished in the place of Oscar Wilde. The importance of being an and Lady Windermere's fan derived their strength from witty dialogue and comic situations. So in the place of Oscar Wilde, especially with the importance of being Ernest and Lady Windermere's fan, and other Bernard Shaw and Galsworthy play, comedy dialogues and comic situation provoked laughter. It's not like including fantasy or magic elements, which would never happen in human life, but within real life, with the witty dialogues, powerful laughing dialogues and situation, audience are provoked to laugh. Okay, so there are great comedy writers, Oscar Wilde, Bernard Shaw, Galsworthy. And Shaw's play deals with a social problem, and comedies are characters with intellectual wit, irony and satire. Apart from penetrating analysis of social and moral problems confronting society. especially Bernard Shaw's comedies focus more on social problems, and social problems are satirized in his plays. Okay, some of his important plays are Arms and Man, Apple Cart, Major Barbara, and John Bull's Other Island. Okay, they are all important comedies written by Bernard Shaw in English literature, and they focus on social issues. An experimental playwright who wrote Influence of Shaw was James Brady. His themes covered a wide range and plays like The Anatomist and Mr. Balfrey were great and successful comedies. Under the influence of Bernard Shaw, James Brady was also wrote a great comedies in English literature, and some of him are Antomonist and Mr. Balfrey. Okay, we shall move to the next paragraph. The latter half of the present century saw plays with little literary merit succeeding on the stage. But in the modern age, in the 21st century, comedies were written but with little literary merit. We cannot call the plays as great plays. But of course, they had a commercial success. Audience laughed a lot, but they are not that great comedies. Though, only for the time being, for the such audiences, the laughter was provoked. But in the 20th century, not great comedies were written. The audience wanted only entertainment, so a playwright provided a dialogue that made good impression, and situation tickled the audience into laughter. The theater became tangle of illusion, make believe. Okay, so from the beginning of 20th century, no great comedies were written because audience wanted only entertainment. They don't want any literary value in it. Okay, so because of that, not great comedies were written in English literature, and it was made a kind of illusion and make believe. Okay, so it cannot happen in real life, and just silly and foolish comedies were written, and for the time being, the comedies were audience laughed. But after that, today if we read their comedies, we don't feel any kind of laughter. Just for the time being, they got entertainment and laughter, but today we cannot enjoy or read their, or even to be performed on the stage. Worst dramas, worst comedies were written. Among the playwright of this kind foremost was Newell Howard, who plays with leisure classes. He became popular with the plays with the Hay Fever and the Happy Breed. Though foolish and not great dramas were written, Newell Howard, of course, he's not that great, but somewhat he could be remembered today is Newell Howard. Newell Howard is the only play, though he wrote for commercial purpose, audience laughed a lot for the time being, but still his Hay Fever, The Happy Breed are a great plays. J.B. Priestley, the author of Time and Conway's, and John Overdon, they are all other great plays written by J.B. Priestley. And other important playwrights were Tennessee, Ratigan, and who wrote the Winslow Boy, and of course, and other playwrights are James Berry, and James Berry's admirable Chilton, and so they deal with serious social problem, and the dialogue also provoked the laughter, but today they are not such great playwright. Okay, so that's the end of this topic, comedy. Thank you.